Hello everyone, Heidi Blankenship here for Tutorial Tuesday with Just Right Paper Craft. And today I will be sharing the Just Right Binder Box Storage System with you. This is a wonderful storage system for cling mount stamps, background stamps, and die templates. So this video is going to be just a little bit different than most of my other videos, and I will be talking and sharing the storage system with you throughout the video, and then I will also add in a few still shot pictures. So let's get started. Okay, the first thing that we're going to do is take a look at the binder box. This is the binder box here, and it measures 9.5 by 7 3/16 by 1 3/8. Okay, and the binder box is translucent. Now, if you order the binder boxes right off of the Just Right website, they do come with the paper insert, and then you can write the different stamp sets that you have on there. This one here, I've removed the insert from it just for the video purpose today, but I will be showing you the inserts too. So but anyways, on the side here there is like a little clip to open and close, and that keeps it shut nice and tight so all that your stamps will stay inside. And then here on the inside are like little ring binders, and they pop up. And then you can put the panels that the stamps come on, you can insert those in here, and then you can just pop these back in place, and it will hold all of them. Okay, and then I'm going to flip this around. Oops, sorry about the glare there. You'll be able to see from the back side of this, right here is like a clear overlay on the storage box, and it goes all the way from the front cover to the side panel to the back. Okay. And this is where you insert the binder box inserts that will either come with the binder box or the ones that are printable that you can download from the website, which we'll be talking about. Okay, and doing that allows you to customize and to identify which stamp sets are in each binder. It's a perfect storage solution for the Just Right cling stamps and the background stamps, and you can also store your die templates in it, and it makes it easy to take your stamps with you, like if you're going to a class or a crop or something. So very nice and convenient. Okay, so next we're going to take a look at the storage panels. Okay, we're going to take a look at the storage panels. Now, when you purchase a stamp set or a background stamp from Just Right, this is the storage panel that you'll get, and it's nice heavy-duty plastic. It already has the holes punched out in it, and one side here shows a beautiful color image of the stamp, and then up here you will see the name of the stamp set. It also tells you the size of it, and this one here happens to be a background stamp, but on the actual cling stamp sets it will tell you also like how many stamps are in the set. And then up here is the SKU number. And then right here it also tells you who the designer is. And this particular stamp set was designed by Amy Tedder. Okay. Now the back side is just plain white, but it allows the cling stamp to stick to it very nicely. Okay. So this is what they come like when you order the different stamp sets, whether it's a background stamp or a stamp set. So then you can also order additional storage sheets if you would like. You can use these to store your die templates on, or if you have other stamp sets that you would like to store, you can also store them on these cling sheets. And this here is a pack of four, and these are just blank, and this is what they look like. So they don't have any images on them or anything. So okay, so that is a look at the storage sheets. Okay, now we're going to move on to the binder box insert printables. And these can be found on the Just Right Papercraft website. And it is a PDF file that you can purchase and download. And once you've purchased it and downloaded it, then you can print these out as many times as you would like. And they're really great to use for organizing and customizing your storage boxes. So we'll take a look at the ones that are available. Okay, and this just prints out like on a standard size sheet of paper, And they do have to be trimmed down a little bit, which I will be showing you that in just a minute. But this one here is Amazing Paper Grace. So right away, just at a first quick glance of this, you know, if you have the storage box, that all the stamps that are in there, or the die templates, that those are going to be ones that were designed by Becca Feakin. Okay. Now next is Amy Tedder. She's another one of the designers for Just Right Paper Craft, and she designs a lot of the stamp sets and some of the die templates. Okay, and then we have Samantha Walker, and she also designs stamps and die templates. Okay, and then here is one that's just blank. So, you know, it's up to you which you would like to use, if you want to use one with the designer's name on it, or if you would like to use the blank ones. And then this here is another insert printable that you can get, and this is for the side panel of the storage box. Show you that over here real quick. Okay, so these would go right along here on the side. So if you have these up like on a bookcase like this, at a really quick glance, you're going to be able to see what stamps are in your storage box. And these list out in here, there's Christmas stamps, cling stamps, background stamps, and die templates. Okay, so that's just a look at the binder box insert printables that are available. And like I said, those are a PDF file. Okay, and now I'm gonna be showing you the inserts on storing my Christmas stamps. Here I have one of the binder box insert printables, and this one here is one for Amy Tedder Designs. Okay, and I've cut it down to size, so I trimmed off the excess paper. And now to insert these, I'm just going to open the box up all the way, and then you can just insert the paper. Lined up there. Okay. And then you can close the box, and then you can just kind of run your fingers along the side to create like a little crease. Okay. All right. So then this is what it would look like once the insert is in place. And before you would insert those, you could go ahead and you could write down the different stamp sets that are in the box. I'm going to slide this out for one more second here just to show you something. I wanted to show you the side panels that you can also cut out. Okay, so here's one that's been trimmed out, and this is for background stamps. Now this binder here is going to hold my Christmas background stamps that were designed by Amy Tedder. Okay, so if you want, you can cut out this side panel, and you could just use some adhesive to attach it over here. However, when you do that, then you're going to cover up the little spot down here where it says Amy Tedder. And I like to know at a really quick glance what is in my storage boxes. So another option that you can do, if you want to be able to know, you know, exactly what stamps you have in there, you can trim off the ends, and then you can just use some adhesive to adhere this in place once you write the names of your stamps on there. Okay, so like I said, you would just write the names of your stamp, and then you can use a tape runner and adhere that to the side, and then you would just insert it up at the top. Okay. Okay, now I just wanted to show you what this looks like when it's done. I have the insert in place, and I used adhesive to adhere the smaller piece that I had. And I've written down my stamps that are in the container. And on this one here, I wrote right underneath here, I did write Christmas BG for Christmas background. And then I've listed the ones that are going to be in the storage box. And then also on the back here, it does say background stamps, but I wanted to know that it was going to be Christmas background stamps, so I just wrote that above there. And, you know, it's up to you however you would like to customize this and personalize it. Whatever is going to be the most helpful for you personally with organizing and stuff. But now if this is sitting on the edge of the shelf, I know at a very quick glance, this is my Just Right Paper Craft stamps, and these are the ones designed by Amy Tedder. and their Christmas background stamps, and then it lists the four different stamp sets that are going to be inside the storage box. Okay, so go ahead and just open this up. And then I'm going to pop these open here. And then I'll show you just how quick and easy it is to insert these. So we'll just insert those there. Like I said, these come already with the holes are punched out in them. And the storage boxes will hold four of these panels with the background stamps. Okay. And then once you get them into place, you can just snap those in there. Okay, now they're all very secure. And then when this is open all the way to, it's very nice and easy to be able to move these so that you can look at the different stamp sets and stuff. So, okay. So this is a look at how I store the Christmas background stamps. And next I'm going to be sharing with you how I store die templates in the same system. Okay, now the last thing that we're going to take a look at is how I store die templates using the binder box and also the binder box insert printables. Okay, so here's the same binder box, and as you can see, I have one of the insert printables in here, and this particular one is for Amazing Paper Grace. And so at a very quick glance, I will know that these are die templates that were designed by Becca Feakin. Okay. And then on the front part right here, I did write die templates, and then I've listed the ones that I have in the storage box, or in the binder box here. And then I'm going to just turn this on the side so you can see. I did use the shorter version where I cut down the sides, but it's up to you, whichever, you know, if you want to, if you want to be able to use, you know, like the longer strip, or if you want to cut it down. I just like having it cut down so then I can see the logo down here for Amazing Paper Grace. So then I just very quick glance, I know that those are the particular die templates that were from that designer. So, and then I've listed the different die templates that are in here. So you can use, like I said, this here is one of the insert printables that I've used. Okay, and then I'm just going to open the box and show you how I store the dies. Now, since I'm on the design team, a lot of times when we get die templates or if we get different stamp sets, sometimes we get prototypes. So I don't happen to have the images, but you could use an image from your packaging. And you could just take that and cut it out. And then you could use like a tape runner adhesive to adhere this to the insert panel here. Okay, then I'll just flip this around, and I've just used a piece of magnet to hold the die templates in place. Okay, so you can very easily store your die templates here, and if you use like your packaging, or like I printed these images out here, but I can see the image of the die template, and I can see the die cuts that I can get from it, and then also the name of the die template set and how many dies are in the set. And then I also know that these are all Amazing Paper Grace. Okay, and you can store, I would say you could very comfortably and easily store at least six of these panels in here to be able to turn the pages on them. Now, if you don't have the images, or if you don't, it doesn't bother you to, you know, you're not interested in having the images, then what I would do, you could store a whole lot more dies in these. You could store them on the front and on the back. And you could just put your magnet strips a lot closer together, and you could fit several different die template sets on here. And then if you have a label maker, or even if you don't have a label maker, you could take like mailing labels and put them up in the corner, and you could write the name of the die template on them. But that's just another option too, where you could store a lot more die sets. Okay, so I'm going to set this aside for just a minute, and I'm just going to show you, like, if you had the packaging from your die set, and you can just take some adhesive. Pop this in place on one side. Okay, and then we'll flip this over. And then on the back side, you can take the magnet strip here. Okay, and this just comes in a roll. This is found in a lot of different big box stores. Okay, and the nice thing about this is you can cut off whatever length that you need, so you won't be wasting any of it. So what I usually do is take my die template and kind of hold it up on there so I can see, and you know, about how big of a piece that I want. And then I'm just going to take that and cut it. Okay, and then another little tip is if you take, because this is wound up on a roll, it has a curve to it, but if you take this and bend it back and forth a few times, it's going to flatten it out a lot more for you. And so then it'll be, it will stick down to the panel a lot nicer, and hopefully the corners won't come up for you. So you're just going to peel the backing off. Okay. And then press that down in place. And then adhere your die template. Okay? So very quick and easy to do that. And then you can just pop it right in place. So very easily there, you can see how using the binder box storage system and the binder box insert printables that are in a PDF file, how you can store your cling stamps, your background stamps, and your die templates and stuff. So makes for really great storage and everything. So, but I think that's it for me today. So this kind of wraps it up. And if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them down below or on the Just Write blog. We always love and appreciate hearing from you. And if you liked today's video, please give us a thumbs up. We really appreciate it. And be sure to check on the Just Write website to see all the products and the Just Write blog for lots of inspiration from the design team. So thanks so much for joining me today, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.